Hey guys, we're here at Trimble Park today. Pretty exciting. We've already seen this red-shouldered hawk here. They're pretty neat little birds. I shouldn't say little. They get to be 24 inches tall at the tallest. They live anywhere from 15 to 19 years. The longest one recorded in the wild got up to be 23 years. They eat fish, mice. We just saw a bass bones over there, a pretty nice sized bass too, so I'm thinking this guy or another hawk probably ate it. They're beautiful birds though, so we're really excited to see what else we can find here at Trimble Park today. Right over here is an imbinga. Oh, there it goes. So they're water dwelling birds. Right now it's drying its wings out. It's also talking to us, telling us it doesn't want us here. If you ever see them while you're on the water, they're the ones who dive down in the water and swim, and they'll disappear and you won't see them anymore. Pretty neat birds. They eat small fish and stuff like that. Kind of annoying. Alright you guys, so kind of gross, but right here is what I believe to be bear poop. Not a very large bear, I'd say, but I definitely think that's what it is. Maybe we'll find them. Alright you guys, so right here is a very tiny gator, okay? He might be dead. But no, he's alive. Okay, so it's illegal to catch gators in Florida, okay? I would never catch a gator. All right, so anyways, so these guys actually grow 1 to 2 feet every year for the first 8 years of their life. So you can kind of judge how big they are based on that. So for the first 2 years of their life, their mama will be somewhere around. So unless this little guy has been isolated, you can probably bet that mama is somewhere around, okay? This little guy's covered in algae. I'm really not sure if he's alive or not, so I'm not gonna touch him. Cause that's illegal. I'm just gonna see if I can get him to move. Let me make sure mama's not under here to eat my hand. When I do. Yeah, he's alive. Cool, so that's a pretty neat find. Gators are really cool. So that guy, I would say, is probably a month or two old. For when they're that size, they'll eat minnows, small fish, and frogs. When they get bigger, they'll eat mostly fish and frogs. Sometimes they'll eat birds. It really doesn't occur that often. The woods, as you can hear, are very alive right now. It's awesome. I love that sound. Right over here in front of me, we got what I believe to be a pig frog. I don't know anything about them, but I think it's a pig frog. Alright you guys, so that was a brown anole. If you guys have ever been out in your backyard or basically anywhere in Florida, you guys have definitely seen the brown anole. They come in many different colorations and stuff like that. That was just one of them. They're always brown. They can actually change colors, but it's always a shade of brown. So if you've ever caught one and it's changed colors on you, then that's why. They are actually invasive to Florida. They are an invasive species, yet the most populous lizard that we have in Florida. They're often confused with the green anole. The green anoles, we're going to try and find one today, but the green anoles are actually native to Florida, and the numbers have started to go down since these brown anoles have been taking over. But we'll find a green anole to show you, to hopefully, you know, so you can tell the difference between the two. But pretty neat fact about those lizards are that they're invasive. So always a little water snake. Okay. All right, you guys. So we have a beautiful little banded baby water snake. This guy is freshly hatched. He hasn't even shed his first skin yet. He's absolutely beautiful. Okay. You can see how vibrant his colors are and how gorgeous he is. These guys are so cool. So a couple facts about water snakes that I didn't tell you guys last time. Water snakes actually can have venom in their bite. It's not dangerous to humans. It's mostly just for their prey. So it's mostly only found in the bigger ones. It's really just bacteria. So I'm just looking at how pretty he is. They will bite their, like a fish or something, and then the fish will swim off and it'll actually kill the fish and they'll track it in the water. And it's really neat. That's something really cool about water snakes. This little guy is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Man, I'm so happy. I'm gonna put him right back where I found him. There you go, buddy. Awesome. Alright you guys, that was our video for today. I hope you enjoyed. Like and subscribe, comment, something positive, please. We found some pretty neat stuff today. You guys can hear the gators talking back and forth in the background, pretty neat. We got some pretty neat stuff today. We only got our hands on one snake. We saw two black rat snakes today, but couldn't get our hands on them, unfortunately. We'll definitely be hitting this place again. We're in Trimble Park in Mount Dora. Pretty awesome park. I would definitely suggest coming to it. You guys get out there and explore.